guys, and welcome back to Relax My Dog. Today me and Milo are going to be sharing with you our top 5 family dogs. So if you are looking for a dog for your growing family, then do watch this video. So there are a lot of dogs that work really, really well as family dogs, but today I'm going to particularly talk about 5 different dog breeds with you guys. So these aren't going to be in any particular order, I'm just going to talk to you about them completely randomly. So the first one is a Springer Spaniel. Now, Springer Spaniel is a very happy dog and it has quite a good sense of humour. They usually do get on with children, especially if they have been brought up from puppyhood. So if you are looking to get yourself a Springer Spaniel as well as a mitt have a family, it is quite a good idea to get them as soon as they are a puppy so that they get used to you and having children in the house. Now, our second top family dog is actually a Border Collie, which we have here. How are you, Milo? So Border Collies are extremely people orientated and they make very, very good family dogs. But it's also important to note that some Border Collies actually don't get on with other dogs and other cats. Milo, if you've seen in our previous videos, he gets on extremely well with Rio, who is our cat. They get on like brothers. They are so, so cute. Especially if you want a dog that can play ball or fetch with your children, Border Collies are great for that because they are extremely, extremely clever. However, it's also important to know that Border Collies do try to herd the family. We've experienced this quite a lot. He likes to run around to make sure he knows where everybody is and tries to sort of enclose everyone into a space. But that is just Milo's nature, isn't it, really? Because he is known for sheep herding. Well, not Milo, but his breed. Now, number 3 is Labrador Retrievers. Labradors are kind, good-natured, and just take anything in their stride when it comes to children. They get on with pretty much all ages, from when your child is baby up to when they are growing up as well. And again, Labradors are very, very fun dogs to play with as well. They come to about maybe a medium size, so they are great for if you do have a growing family, because you don't want a dog that is going to completely overtower your children. Then next up, we have another retriever. This is the Golden Retriever, which is a little bit of a bigger, fluffier dog. Now, a Golden Retriever is known as the classic family companion. They are obedient, playful, and well-mannered, which makes them great to have within the family. They are also very, very good watchdogs, but not necessarily guard dogs, so just take that into consideration. Golden Retrievers are very much a family-orientated dog. They absolutely love being part of the family and playing with your children. And then lastly, we have the Beagle. Now, Beagles are known to be absolutely wonderful dogs. I've never had a Beagle myself. They grow to about a medium size, so it's perfect for if you do have sort of young children within the family. They are just an all-round good pet because they get on with children and they also get on with other pets as well. Most of them are short-haired, and however, some of them do molt, so you might want to take that into consideration when getting a Beagle. And that is it for our top 5 family dogs. Don't forget to give us a big thumbs up if you enjoyed it and if you learned anything new within this video. Also, don't forget to comment down below if what sort of dog you have and whether you think they are family-orientated, because I'm sure a lot of people will want to look down there to see what dogs you guys have as well. Also, don't forget to subscribe and click the little notification bell next door to the subscribe button, as that will keep you notified every single time we upload a brand new video. And me and Milo will see you in our next one. Bye!